Getting started with VocalSynth 2 is easy. Start by selecting a mode in which to use VocalSynth 2 by clicking on the mode icon over here. Now we can use VocalSynth 2 in auto, MIDI, or sidechain mode. VocalSynth 2 automatically detects the host you're working in and gives you easy to follow instructions for setting up the various modes. In auto mode, you can let VocalSynth 2 do its own thing. Insert it on an audio track and just press play. With MIDI mode, you can control the notes and harmonies that VocalSynth 2 generates with a MIDI keyboard or other MIDI device. In sidechain mode, you can drive your favorite synth, guitar, or any other sound through VocalSynth 2 modules, enabling you to turn your favorite audio sources into vocal effects, like sidechaining this pad over a vocal, I feel so much more than I know. Giving the soloed vocal the pad's melody. Here they are together. I feel so much more than I know. I'm really, really ready to go. Everything is gold. No matter which mode you use, you can always map VocalSynth 2 parameters to your MIDI controller to create harmonies or build dramatic moments in your productions. VocalSynth 2 has 5 modules. Let's have a listen to each one, starting with our newest, Biobox. Choose from over 100 global presets, which are categorized between auto and MIDI mode. Not to mention module-specific presets, which you can toggle here to inform the sound engine of the module. Speaking of which, by pressing this button, deeper controls are revealed, giving you more control for sculpting and enhancing your sound. Modules can be toggled on and off here, and blended together using these sliders. But we can also blend these sounds from the animation itself, located in the center of the user interface, by dragging these little sliders. As we add more modules to the mix, the animation reacts in real time. Of course, we can always go to the XY pad to control 2 assignable parameters, in this case, the vocoder level and the polybox level. On the left, we have pitch and voicing parameters to create unique scale types, pitch correction processing, and the ability to choose between poly or monophonic MIDI operations, not to mention a fun glide parameter, which behaves like a portamento. Here's the glide parameter in action on a rap track. I am every animal. I am the teeth of cannibals. I was just looking for God. I am the bullet that pop. I am the greatest at rock. Shit to make you think it never better. I was spitting Babby and the Hattis. I've been here showing you love. Musical rising above. It is invisible. This is a miracle job. Moses. Along the bottom are rearrangeable effects for even deeper sound design possibilities, with 2 new effects added. First is the chorus, which adds dreamy richness to your vocal. Here's before. Up into the sky. Up into the sky. We also added a ring mod for fun tremolo effects. Up into the sky. We've also rebuilt the shred module from the ground up. So here's the shred module on, of all things, an acoustic guitar in a rock track, but hear how the shred adds a kind of rhythmic effect to the strumming. I'll play it soloed without the effect, then I'll bring the effect in, and then I'll turn the whole mix on. So that's just the guitar soloed. Now let's turn the shred on. Now let's turn this on in the context of the mix. So I tell myself, it's funny how I can push the pills, but I can't swallow. Finally, on the right, we have global controls. From here, we can set the gate threshold. This is to minimize the occurrence of room noise or breaths, any non-musical information being processed by VocalSynth 2. We can alter the global panning of the sum of our processing by shifting it from left to right. I've been waiting for you, you to see. We can affect the width, the stereography of this sound by creating a more wide with you or narrow effect. And finally, we have the global wet dry fader here to control the overall amount of dry or process signal that we're outputting. Thanks for watching. Please click on our other videos to learn how to make the most of VocalSynth 2.